So first of all, Tank, this is the Tank era. When did this era start?
Probably like a little under a year.
Boxing superstar, 3-division champion Gervonta Davis beat Frank Martin last night. He got the knockout in the 8th round. Tank has improved to 30-0 with 28 knockouts. After the fight, I caught up with Tank and the event, a lot of top success.
He spoke with the media
the day before.
So I'm going to share with you some of the things that he said.
So one thing that came up, they asked him, why does he have Beyonce as a screensaver? Here's what Gervonta has to say. Check it out. Tank, I guess the event wasn't canceled.
By the way, Zab was my guy, and Zab was my favorite fighter before Floyd came out. For sure.
Off the topic, we've got a sneak peek of your locker screen with Beyonce.
Yeah.
Fans talk about it.
Yeah, fire, right? I like females with Yankee hats on. There's something about it.
What if Jay-Z gets mad at that?
No, not like, not trying to hit on her, but you know what I mean?
Jay-Z, my guy,
you're trying to get me in trouble.
Tank was then asked about a fight between David Benavidez and Canelo Alvarez. Who does he have in that fight? Check out what he has to say.
If Canelo and Benavidez do fight, who do you have in that fight?
Come on, man. Both of them are my guys. I'd be a boxing fan. But that'd be a good fight, though.
Who's the hardest puncher in boxing? You, Emily, or B2B? Pound for pound, hardest puncher in boxing, regardless of weight class.
Me. I gotta say me, right?
The champ was asked, what does he do to unwind after such a huge win?
Unwind?
After
this victory. I don't know, probably grab food, chill, probably sleep. Probably chill for sure. Stay out there.
Thank you, man. Phenomenal shake these past 14 months. Is it right back to work or you
want to
take a layoff?
Nah, I gotta get right back to work. Probably like a week now. At first, I was taking a little minute off, but now I gotta get back, probably like a week or two. I say a week or two.
Right here in the middle.
Right here.
Thank you.
The pound for pound king, Gervonta, was asked, what did he learn when he caused Frank Martin to flinch when they faced off during fight week? And Tank gave an interesting answer. Check it out.
Hey! Oh!
What was your thoughts when he flinched at the weigh-in? You had him?
Yeah, I knew I could get him with my feints in the fight. That's why you see when I fainted him in the ring, jump back. That's when I start picking up too. Like, he will be in front of me, but if I'm about to throw something, he'll back all the way up. So I knew I had to like stay in his face and like keep my guard high. And by the way, I got this from blocking, he just punching this, so he didn't actually catch me, you know what I mean? So it happens though.
What do you say about all the people that say you had a lot of nervous energy this week just because you've been talking more and more vocal, so people really get to see who Gervonta is all about? What do you say to them?
It's just an on and off switch, you know what I mean? Just trying to build up and sell a fight. That's it.
How effective do you think the mental games were this week?
I can't really tell though, like if it's like probably then and there, but I don't know how it would affect in the ring because people can be like, I don't know.
Tank has had 28 knockouts out of 30 fights. 28 knockouts is like 95% knockout ratio. Here's Tank, the quiet before the storm, in his locker room. Very calm, very cool, getting some inspiration, a good talk from Calvin Ford, his coach, who's been with him since day one. Since he got in the gym, they've been together pretty much over 25 years. So they're a family. And look at the shirts. Who are you going to call Ghostbusters? In the back is the Ghostbusters because Frank Martin's nickname is the Ghost. So Tank was asked about the knockout.
My,
out of all your knockouts, this one.
I don't know.
Hey, Tank.
question for you. So I know you said, obviously, you're getting tired a little bit of having to worry about what you're going to do to somebody, what somebody's going to do to you. Everybody knows you're a hard-hitting guy, you're a tough guy, but do you think some of this stuff ever gives you anxiety at all?
Yeah. Yeah, that's why I like to do stuff that I do every day, like normal day type stuff. Just so I can psych myself out, not, you know what I mean, overthink and stuff like that.
Can you talk about that a little bit? Like, obviously, you know, for most people, they would think Tank Davis knocks people out. He don't get anxiety. He don't deal with any of that stuff. Can you talk a little bit about it?
I feel like everybody gets anxiety. It's just how you go about it, you know what I mean?
The rapper that walked Tank out, his name is OTR Chaz. He's from Baltimore. He's extremely talented and he has a great voice. And that really brought down the house. Here's what Tank has to say.
A guy that I'm working with, Fire, on the come up.
Who's the one to move you out next?
It don't matter.
You heard him with the uppercut. Did you see him out on his feet, that set up that overhand left where it was just beautiful like that?
I knew I caught him with a good shot. I didn't know he was out on his feet. But I knew for sure I caught him with a good shot with the uppercut.
What is it about you when you're in that mode where you just go, where it's no mercy, where you just got to get him out of there?
I know how to read my opponent.
Anthony Peterson, a good friend of mine, he starts saying that your power translates to 175. And people kind of laugh at that. You feel like everyone is starting to follow that lead about how your power just...
Yeah.
You can't put a finger on me.
I think it's more so, it's my power and it's also my accuracy too. I think that's what make it just...
Gervonta. I'm not taking it personally that he laughs every time he looks at me. He's like, really? This guy? Is this who I'm going to play?
Did you know that Fred Hardy used to wrestle? I know you mentioned that when he would clinch, it was hard to get off of
him. Yeah. I knew he used to wrestle.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I didn't know he was that strong. Like,
yeah.
I didn't let my arms go for shit.
For millions of people around the world, Gervonta Davis is the face of boxing. As we started this video, he is in his era. James Toney, the boxing icon, champion from 160 to heavyweight. 160 to heavyweight, think about it. He knocked out Evander Holyfield, one of the greatest heavyweights of all time. So James Toney says Tank is the face of boxing.
Tonight called you the face of boxing.
I appreciate that, man. Gotta keep it going. For sure.
Gervonta is one of the few fighters that are bigger than belts. Not every fighter could do it. Most fighters need belts. Gervonta has been champion for so many years in three different divisions. Does he want to go for undisputed?
That's like interesting to you?
I mean,
yeah.
I would say it's good as a professional fighter. Yes, it's good. You know what I mean?
It's good. Gervonta, for you, is that something?
Not really. But it's definitely good for the sport and for my legacy, for sure.
Tank was then asked about Turki El-Sheikh from Saudi. News that came out this week that he's planning on buying all the boxing promotions to make a boxing league similar to the UFC.
He's buying it?
He's looking to buy the promotional companies and create his own league. What do you think about
boxing,
that?
Like boxing league.
Like he wants a model like the UFC. Would you willing to participate in something like that?
Okay.
Or do you like how boxing is now?
Yeah. I'm telling you, I need my two Ferraris. But, I mean, I think I don't know. You know, I feel as though he's somebody that he feel like he got the power because he got the cash. So it's like, let me shit on everybody else type shit. Like, let me take it. But I don't know. It's somewhat good, I would say, for the sport. But I don't know. So he want to kick everybody out? It's like all the promoters.
Lock it down,
yeah, that's crazy. Like, see, it's somebody that's want to come in and bogart everything that don't know really too much about it.
Hey, listen, I know you say you want like pretty much everybody, but specifically, who do you want the most?
Everybody. I don't got no picks. So there ain't nobody that I really want. Whoever they give me. Cool.
You want some? Come get some.
When did you come up with the idea for the Ghostbusters?
My team came up with it, and
that was cool
went with it. Yeah.
And are you the ultimate Ghostbuster?
We
Tank was asked, does he want to knock out fighters on the pound for pound list?
There's not too many people on the pound for pound in my weight class, but
yeah, Shakur.
Yeah, but
maybe Lomachenko is still elite.
Sure. Yeah, yeah, for sure. Yeah, yeah, I mean, like I said, they all opponents. You know what I mean? And worthy opponents. And I'm with it all. You know what I mean? I'm at an age where I'm not ducking and dodging nobody. I can just shoot at whoever. You know what I mean? So, This one just about like getting back in the mix, you know what I mean?
They
get better and better.
Shakur, like, you know, pretty much.
Come on,
you know, you feel like it'd be a boring fight, but that it'd be good for boxing and all that. So, yeah. Dude.
I don't want to keep talking about nobody else.
Take you fought in Atlanta, you fought in LA. How does this crowd compare? I saw a lot of Baltimore Orioles here out here.
Yeah, there was a lot of people out here. Different people. I appreciate a lot of Baltimore people. Everybody that was traveling to come to Vegas, though, you know what I mean, see me fight. I appreciate everybody, even y'all. You know what I mean? I appreciate everything.
When you did that backflip, did you feel the energy from the crowd?
Yeah, fire.
Yeah. That's good.
What is left on her boxing bucket list?
Fighting a stadium now.
You want to sell out Allegiant one day?
Yeah. No, I need to fight. That's the Raiders?
Yeah, that's the Raiders.
Yeah.
How about Tank fighting at the Raiders Stadium? How would you like that?
You love it.
I would love it.
Outstanding.
Your brother from another mother, exactly. Gervonta Davis, right. Did it again. How great is Gervonta Davis?
He's the best.
I say number one pound for pound.
He is.
For Davis, he said he wanted you to fight at the Raiders Stadium. He said it was an open door for you.
Yeah, for sure. That's my guy. Just got to get the right people involved. And he'll be a greater man.
Before the Frank Martin fight, Tank was out of the ring for over a year. He was asked, did he feel any ring rust?
Yeah, a little bit. Just a little from like the first couple rounds, just, you know what I mean? Getting a feeling of being in a pro fight, like on that level. You get what I'm saying? Like not even just fighting. But just being in that whole atmosphere, you know what I mean? So it was a little rusty, but as I was going, it was like a little warm up.
Gervonta says Frank Martin was not his toughest opponent. So who was?
You mentioned that Frank wasn't your toughest opponent yet, but could you name who was?
Name who was? Tough opponent. I say,
all impressed you with something?
Because all of them come with different things. Like Ryan was coming with his hook. He was strong. You know what I mean? I couldn't sit there with him. Frank, his jab was strong. No, I'm lying. His brick hand, his left hand was strong. I don't think he really hit me with a hook. So I don't know about his hook, but his jab was decent. His footwork was okay. His footwork better than Ryan. Who else? I mean, they just all come with different styles. That's why you don't never see me fight the same style as I fight before.
What about Pitbull Cruz? A lot of people want that rematch. You willing to give him a rematch? Pitbull Cruz?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, did he impress you with anything?
Yeah, he looked the sharpest last fight. He did what he had to do. We definitely can get a rematch for sure. Hopefully sooner than later.
A few times during the fight with Frank Martin, Gervonta Davis was smiling.
During the fight,
I heard somebody on the outside saying something about like there's no hall with like my childhood school, like when I was in high school or some shit. So that's why I was like, that's what caught my attention. Like he was saying like, I don't know who it was, but I couldn't find out who was saying it, but it was somebody that kept saying something about Disney Harbor, the school I used to go to. I'm like, what?
Somebody take
their homework. He actually caught me when I started paying attention to that. I think he caught me with like a jab or some shit.
Oh, damn.
Leading in to Tank's fight with Frank Martin, Floyd Mayweather posted a poster of the fight with the word canceled upon it. He also posted to watch another fight that night on ESPN, nothing to do with boxing. So Andre Brito and BJ Flores are responding. BJ Flores says, Tank has power and star qualities Floyd Mayweather never had. Nobody cares about sparring. Floyd also released a sparring between Devin and Tank. At this point, nobody cares. Tank is the pound-for-pound king of boxing, the face of boxing. Devin, who claimed to be the pound-for-pound, who claimed to be this is his era, has turned out to be kind of a bust. And no one knows if he's going to ever box again or box at a high level, if he has anything left in the tank at all.
What's your reaction to Mayweather making the claims on X that your fight was canceled the last couple of weeks?
He told Frank that I was running at 5 o'clock, 7 o'clock in the morning, Friday. He told Frank that. He was giving Frank tips and stuff like that.
Really? How'd you know that?
Because I seen his people's drive by while I was running.
Really?
Yeah.
And they were like spying or?
No. He got a club. He got a club called Girl Collection, and it closed at 5 in the morning, 6 in the morning. And they so happened to catch me while I was running. But I knew for sure that wasn't going to be enough to beat me.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Big punch. Nice. Good finish. Okay.
Tank says when it comes to Floyd Mayweather, it's better to beef with him than to be cool with him. He says Floyd could do crazy stuff that will put you in a bad situation.
With Mayweather kind of going back and forth with the love-hate relationship, where do you stand right now?
It's cool. It's I don't really think too much of it. It's not going to hurt me. You know what I mean? So it's good to beef with him than be cool with him, because he can do some crazy stuff. He'll picture him bad situations.
You mentioned that you wanted to fight in Chicago. That was one of the most likely places you wanted to fight in. Do you still want to fight in Chicago?
Yeah, for sure I'll fight in Chicago. Yeah, I'll fight in Chicago. Yeah.
What made you want to say Chicago?
Because Chicago's beautiful, man, besides the bad stuff that they promote. But it's a beautiful city. I've been to Chicago before. Downtown is beautiful, you know what I mean? Actually, it's big, fashion big in Chicago, you know what I mean? So Chicago is definitely a beautiful city that I would like to fight in, for sure.
Tank, you got a message for Floyd? You seem to kind of be hating on him, obviously posted about the fight being canceled and things like that. Any message for Floyd?
We did it.
Hey Tank, your coach said every time you fight a fight, they get better after Mario, Pitbull, Rolly, Ryan. I think Frank Martin's gonna get a lot better after this fight. What do you
think? Yeah, I think he gonna go back to the drawing board and see, look at the fight and see what he messed up at. It was a lot of holes not a lot, but it was just little mistakes that he was doing that I picked up on as the fight was going on.
You think that's that big stage jitters that, you know, he's never been there before, so maybe mistakes. I mean, not taking away your credit, you were definitely deserving the favor of the fight, but you think sometimes a fighter comes in and if they have a game plan, it might be a little off whatever they're trying just because they're fighting you on a big stage?
Yeah, probably so. Well, not probably, but for sure. Because of, you gotta think about somebody trying to knock you out. You know what I mean? So his plan was not to get knocked out. You know what I mean? That's why he was moving a lot and things like that. But I knew what was his game plan. You know what I mean? So I knew that he was gonna try to stay away and box. So that's what made me stay in his face. And also like how Floyd did with Zab. Floyd lost a couple rounds before he wound up taking advantage of the fight, because he knew that Zab was going to get tired. So he stayed in his face. And Zab was sharp too. You cannot say that
Frank not sharp. You know what I mean? He came out pretty decent, and then I just had to come alone.
Do you feel like you're one of those fighters where they always say, like, guys like Floyd and other fighters, they don't get you out in the first two rounds, after three or four, it's done. It's over. The fight's over. Like, there's no way to even...
Yeah, I just start picking up, just like calculating, like, you know what I mean? Just start downloading and things like that. Somebody mistakes, and, like, seeing what they got, what they do good and what they do bad. You know, once you're in there, it's all right watching tapes and stuff like that, but you got to actually be in there with someone and start picking up what they, you know, what they good at and what they're not good at.
Talking about Zeb Judah, he had you for four rounds. His prediction was four rounds. For this fight, yes. And on the topic, we got a sneak peek of your locker screen.
By the way, Zeb was my guy, and Zeb was my favorite fighter before Floyd came out.
Three, two, one, step.
Good.
Okay, we're going to real time.
Shout outs go out to Martin, man. Martin was that guy, and I kept telling you, he was that guy. He came out partying, and Tank told him, you know, a lesson for everybody. When Tank get up and go sparring, he's just checking his parameters. He's checking his measuring stick when he get up and do that. Sparring is just sparring for Tank. I think Tank does that because he just want to get up and hit somebody. When somebody get up and hit him, I keep telling you, that's his peace. And it's just like that for him. You know, that's how he find his energy. You know, did Martin push that button? Yes, he did push that button. Could he keep pushing that button? He did the best that he can, and I told you, there's nothing personal when it comes to this. And speaking of nothing personal, man, I want to give shout-outs to Rolly. Rolly seen me at the MGM, man. Came and gave me a hug, man. And gave me a few pointers. Garcia came and hollered at me, man, you know. He said he loved Tank. He said, but he want to fight him again, you know. But again, it's not beef with us. You know, we in here putting in hard work to get that victory. This camp, man, it had us pulling this way, pulling that way, but we brought it together, man. I want to give shout-outs to our chef. We had a panic moment one day. We had to have pull the meat, and everybody was concerned about Tank health, which we was. I want to give props out for Mad Life coming through, making sure Tank was good and strong and was ready. He said, Kel, that's a well-oiled machine. So I want to give a thanks out to you, man. Your whole team came through for us. And made sure Tank was good. People don't understand that we have a lot of moving parts that's sincere in our circle of what we're doing, you know. The kids, shout outs go out to Martin, man. Martin was that guy, and I kept telling you, he was that guy. He came out partying, and Tank told him, you know, a lesson for everybody. When Tank get up and go sparring, he's just checking his parameters. He's checking his measuring stick when he get up and do that. Sparring is just sparring for Tank. I think Tank does that because he just want to get up and hit somebody. When somebody get up and hit him, I keep telling you, that's his peace. And it's just like that for him. You know, that's how he find his energy. You know? Did Martin push...
Ellie Seckback, reporting.
But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.